Entanglement can be described as engagement with moving parts, potentially causing physical trauma and fatality. When acquiring plant and equipment through purchase or hiring, mine operators should ensure that consideration has been given to safeguarding against the risk associated with entanglement. Critical controls to prevent entanglement include equipment safeguarding to prevent people accessing moving parts, safe standing zones where people remain away from unguarded operating equipment, isolation standards to prevent equipment starting while people are working on or near them, emergency stops to enable stopping of the plant in the event a person becomes entangled. Examples of safeguarding. When introducing a risk control, it is important to conduct a change management process and risk assessment. This is to ensure you have not created another hazard. For example, when burning, plastic guarding gives off toxic fumes, which would require additional risk controls to prevent persons from inhaling them. Guarding fitted to rotating shafts. Rotating elements, such as spinning shafts, must have guards of solid construction designed and fitted to prevent persons from encountering them. Examples of safe standing zones. Performance criteria requires identification of entanglement hazards, including plant, that may start unexpectedly. Risk controls include the implementation of safe standing zones, no-go zones, perimeter fencing, and restricted access barriers. People must be trained and supervised to adhere to safe standing zone requirements. Examples of safe standing zones. Examples of isolation. Effective isolation is used to prevent equipment from starting while people are working on or near entanglement hazards. Performance requirement involves identification of entanglement hazards, isolation locks applied, and tests for dead to ensure that equipment cannot be restarted. Emergency stops, when activated, will not restart plant when unlatched until power has been reset. In conclusion, legacy plant and equipment must be reviewed to ensure that hazards associated with safeguarding requirements have been identified, that risk controls are implemented and maintained to ensure they remain effective against the risk of entanglement. Mine operators must develop a rigorous program of inspection, testing, and maintenance of safeguards for the hazard and ensure it's included in the safety management system.